Good morning students and welcome to the English class. Today we will discuss the remaining part of the lesson We Are Not Afraid to Die If We Can All Be Together by Gordon Cook and Ellen East. In the previous two sessions we discussed about how Ellen Cook, who is the writer or the narrator of the story, he wishes to accomplish a dream which he took almost 16 years ago about when this chapter was written. He had a wish that he wants to imitate Captain James Cook's world voyage, and for that he took 16 years to cover up that skills. When he was assured to get those skills, he get a boat built by the name of Wave Walker. He tried it for a few months. When he was assured that it can support him to travel across the world, then in 1976 he decides to take his family for a sea journey. So they start from Plymouth, England, and then they reach to the coast, and from there they start to Indian Ocean. Their problem begins when they enters the Indian Ocean, which is known to be the toughest ocean in the world. As soon as they spend their Christmas safely, the situation starts becoming unfavorable to them from January 2. In the session, we discussed about what happened actually on 2nd January. The weather became so unfavorable that there was huge waves in the ocean, as well as the sky was over with the heavy clouds, as well as the waves were very strong. So they had to stop the speed of, or they had to control the speed of the boat, and they had to throw up their jibs and have to take precautionary measures for it. Today we will discuss what happened on January 2. So on January 2, when they were all ready to do it, so the waves that hit the deck, and it was broken into pieces, and it was a tough time, because the boat was totally smashed by a huge or the gigantic wave, and there was water on the boat, and it was a part of the boat was badly damaged. They all were injured, and a narrator who was badly injured, he did not care of himself, and he thought that he should do something to let the water out of the boat. So he tossed into stormy water, and then he accepts that he is going to get die. When the narrator feels that he is going to get die, he makes some precautionary things. What he does, first he gets his consciousness and he starts looking at his family members. He goes to children's deck and then he starts looking at them. So, and on the other part, the crew members, which were Larry Vigil and Herb Seazler, what they did, they started looking at the things like the pump. They started looking at the pump, but that pump also stopped working in between. So narrator, he was badly injured, as well as his rib was cracked. Although his the teeth were also broken and he was badly injured, he did not lose his hope. He kept faith in him, as well as he kept determined at that situation. So next we'll discuss today, like, it was a struggle everywhere. So the title given, struggle everywhere. So what happened, Larry and Herb, who were the crew members, who a narrator has taken with them, they started pushing out the water like the madman, because the pump which they had, it stopped working. So they started putting out the water, otherwise their boat would have sank. So if would have sunk, so the narrator, he reaches the children's cabin just to ensure whether his children are okay. So when he reaches the children's cabin, he saw Suzanne. Suzanne is narrator's daughter, who is 7 years old, and Suzanne has a huge bump on head. It was bleeding badly, and narrator although because he wants to save children, he saw the wounds of the children and he did not care of them, and he does not worry about the wounds, but he wants to save all of them because the boat was getting full of water. So he comes back to deck. So he leaves the children behind, and because children were very determined in the lesson, so they give few courage to the parent. So so narrator does not worry about it. He comes back to deck and makes necessary repairs. So whatever the repairs are required to save the boat to get sunk, so he starts doing the repair work, as well as he finds that the water hand pump which they had, it also got blocked. So what happened when it got blocked, as they had taken extra material with them, so he uses the reserve electric pump which was kept in chart room. So when he looks at that the pump is blocked, he rushes to the chart room, and from there he uses the reserve electric pump, right? As well as he sent some midday calls. Here midday calls means some emergency helplines which is given in the sea. So even then he get disappointed because he did not get reply to the midday calls. So situation also was not too favorable to them. And even the daughter's injury, when he went to see the children, daughter's injury was so worsen, as well as her head and eyes were getting swollen, as well as she had a cut on her arms. So she was the one who was badly injured. But out of this, who gave them the courage, who gave courage to the narrator to save it, is the children. So Suzanne, who is daughter, and Jonathan. So Jonathan, who is 6 years old boy, he makes both the children make a card for their parents, for their father, and they write these lines. The title of the lesson is taken from Jonathan's word. So Jonathan tells his father that we are not afraid to die if we can all be together. So these words give courage to the narrator to save all the members in the boat. So that is why the title has been taken from the dialogues of the Jonathan. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. So he gets more courage and he become more determined to save the lives of the people in the save the life of his family members, as well as the crew members, also trying hard to save all of them. So what happened, the day passes on in taking out the water. From last 36 hours were spent, and they were just taking out the water or putting out the water, pumping out the water from the boat. And on January 3, the same time, they thought that narrator who goes to the chart room, he looks at the map and they believe that they will reach the nearest place then they can travel to is the Australia, but that was quite far away from their place. So this they decided that whatever the small island they will find, they will definitely go to hold on there, and from there they will send the midday calls or send the emergency messages and try to save their lives with the help of the local people. So now on January 3, situation was little eased. So the boat was although probably damaged, but some part of it was saved. So the captain had doubt that they could reach Australia, but captain knows that something must be done if we want to save everybody's life. Since the Suzanne, who is narrator's daughter, she is injured. All the other members in the boat are injured. Even narrator got his ribs broken. So that's why he got a crack on the ribs. So they want to save. So the problem, then captain, what happened? He take up the strong jib and he started moving. He look at that we should go to the east. So when they find that if we go towards east, we will find an island. It is Island Amsterdam. From there, they will take help of the local people and will recover recover themselves, as well as they will be able to save the life of all other members. So on January 3, again the weather becomes so unfavorable. Again the sky was there were clouds on their above their heads, as well as the weather was again becoming tough for them. But later on the wind speed gets slowed down and it could not turn up to be more disastrous to them. But on 3rd January, the weather once again made them frightened that if the high waves rise in the ocean, definitely they are all going to get die. But the day passed up doing the work as well as just to save the life, and the narrator who kept on moving toward the east because he wants to see any of the isle or the island which comes on their way, they will stop their boats and save the lives. This is how. And then on January 4, there was 4 and 5, the captain and crew member have pumping out the water from 36 hours, as I told, and there was little water left on the boat. So these 3 days were again tough for them, but on 4th it was a little okay for them. 4th and 5th, so captain hoists the jib and moves to the direction of two islands. So they were expected that there were again clouds. So as I said, the Indian Ocean is likely to be the toughest weather. So they were not sure whether they'll be able to successful to reach to any island because the weather was not supporting them. Once again there were clouds on the sky and they thought that they should move towards east. And few kilometers, like around 4 or 5 o'clock, they should reach to any island. Since they were all sleeping, they had been working so hard to take out the water and little water was left in it. They were so tired that they slept. They slept in the boat and they were expected to reach to the island around 4 o'clock. But they all fell asleep, and suddenly when they got up, they thought that they passed away the island and they find no hope for themselves. But they were surprised to see that they could not pass that island, and at last they reached the island Amsterdam. So when they reached the island Amsterdam, so children were very happy to look at the success of the father. They said, "You are the best father in the world," because he could manage to save the lives of all the people in the boat. So this was the toughest experience that he has ever got in his life. So that they reached island and they were welcomed by the people of the Amsterdam, local residents of the Amsterdam. They helped them, provided them medical facilities, they provided them with food, and they welcomed them wholeheartedly. Later on, he completed his travel till Amsterdam, and then children's reaction was very good, and this is how they got their survival. So this lesson gives us the theme that whenever we have difficult situation in life, we should not lose our hope. We should always be hopeful. We should always have faith in ourselves, and we should always keep courage to overcome all the problems, and we should not let ourselves let down in any situation, whether it is good or worst for us. So this lesson has a theme, as we discussed in the first session and the other sessions, like when you have a strong determination, it can lead you to the success. And then you have support of your families, then you can also accomplish all the things, whatever the challenges there in your life. So the lesson gets completed with its some detailed summary, and at last narrator become a successful captain who could save the life of all crew members as well as his family members, and they reach Isle Amsterdam at last. So this lesson is such a motivational lesson, and I request all the students to read the lesson carefully, because when we have a good reading habits, we'll be able to find out good vocabulary words given in the detailed lesson. You can underline those words, because some of the good word has been used, like for the boat, you will get to know the parts of the boat, like deck. Some of the words are there, like jib and mast. So these are some of the parts of the boat, as well as there are good vocabulary words used in this chapter also, that we will discuss in the coming video. So keep watching that, and till then take care of yourself. Thank you and have a nice day.